That's why I talk so much shit.
If you would advise a chapter for somebody to read, and what would be the best chapter?
I advise you to start from the beginning, because the beginning of the book, actually, he starts off with definitions. A lot of definitions, and a lot of people have opinions about what things say, mm-hmm. and don't have a definitive definition of things, what things say. So the way he start off the book, he start off with definitions. He start off with definitions like enemy, second class citizen, colonialism, hate, antipathy, oppression, nationality, denationalized, genocide, nationalism, things like that. Like, we speak those words a lot, but not a lot of people are very educated in what they mean and how those words function in our society.
Right.
So I think that right there was a great way for him to start off the book, because now it puts you in a state of facts instead of a state of opinions.
Because we just saying it in the conversation, just saying it off the word.
And so, you know, we have been so institutionalized thinking of where we discredit each other. We can't see our brothers or sisters in a higher power, whether mentally or in a physical position. So whenever they give us some knowledge, we automatically knock it down. So when you just see the black and white facts, it's like, this is the definition of them. And he gives examples under each definition. Mm-hmm. So he puts it to where he paints a picture for you, to where after you have read the definition of it, now you can visualize an example of that definition in practice.
Now I got a question. Now, who are some of your four leaders? I'm sure it probably changed throughout the years, but who are some of your leaders that you look up to that basically inspire you?
When I first woke up, it was my first cousin, Flap. He the one that brought me into the truth. He like, cut, I'm gonna tell you the truth if you wanna learn it, because he can't shout a video for him. I had woke up and I was digging into everything. Mm-hmm. And he just so happened, he came home to Franklin. And he was like, say, cut, I'm gonna shoot you a video. He was on the school for director or something. You know, he was like, I'm gonna shoot you a video. And he was like, come on, let's go on Grandma Street. And so after we shot the video, he was like, say, cut, I see you digging into all kind of stuff now that you didn't woke up. But I woke up at first and I just went digging on my own.
Yeah.
And then my cousin came to me and he was like, I'm gonna tell you, once he put me on that path, I've been gone since then. Now, after him, I come from Flap. And after Flap, I really was on my own. I come across Brother Boy, Israel of God out of Chicago. He gave me a lot of basis on just how to read the Bible. Like, a lot of people tried, well, he gave me how to study the Bible, mm-hmm. not how to read it. He gave me how to study the Bible. And then from there, I was able to study it in a different a viewpoint, that I was viewing it from a European standpoint.
Right.
And he taught me how to view it from an African standpoint. Mm-hmm. So now I view the scriptures from a different standpoint, but now I go back into like the Dead Sea Scrolls.
Right.
Then I go back into the Epic of Gilgamesh and I start reading how, you know what I'm saying, how the stories and the information came over time and how it got to this point. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, like Garvin said, man, what I... knowledge of his history and origin of his culture is like a tree without his root.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I go past just the King James. I go to digging in it, all of it. And once I go to digging in it, I start seeing that my people actually wrote this shit. Like, when it gets to the Bible, yes, the crackers got to it. But before this and all this shit back here, mm-hmm. where it come from, it come from my people. So it'll be disrespectful for me to know that this comes from my people and my people are trying to tell me something. And now I don't go back and see what the hell my people are trying to tell me, because now in this modern day era, somebody else got their hand to it before I can get it.
You see, it looks like too, because, you know, a lot of these youngsters don't want to listen. They don't want to listen. And see, it's what it sounds like to you. And from what, you know, we pick up on our OGs, and that's what you did. You know what I'm saying? You took, like, let's just say he gave you the message. You already knew the message, but you just add fire to it. You add more fuel to it.
You gotta incorporate it though. Everybody has, the message is saying the same thing, but in order for you to be able to take it, digest it, and live it, and be able to teach somebody else it, they're gonna have to take it in a different way. You know what I'm saying? You being the person that learned it has to understand that in order for you to teach it, not everybody's gonna learn it the way you learn.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So as a teacher, you have to go into like, all right, let me see how my student learns. See, I know I have people that learn all different ways, but I have people, my spectrum is so broad, so I can't just teach y'all online how everybody else teach y'all. My spectrum is not everybody else's spectrum.
Right. So, do you think, like just say, I flip it. It's just these 90 babies, right? I know, we had to talk about this in the car. They're getting, the soft generation is rude. It's not, you know, it's a lot of feminine ways going on. Don't you think that takes, that took away from taking the man out the house? And then
that's all coming with the institutionalized thinking. Like, first they did it to our body. Well, I know a lot. First they did it to our mind because they got us to think that inclusion,
right,
that us being integrated was inclusion. You know what I'm saying? The illusion of inclusion. They got us thinking that. So they got us to think that, so we integrated. Mm-hmm. But once we integrated, they were able to get into our mind, into our workspace. They were able to get into our household and break us up our household. So at bad as we want to say that these 90 babies heirs and all that stuff, that comes from our elders and before us from being tricked into thinking that everything was all peaches and cream with them and wanted to integrate.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That's where that comes from. So that's where the disconnect starts at. Whenever we decided that we wanted to be all one, the peaches and cream, this ain't kumbaya.
Yeah, because it's not our land. We ain't supposed to be.
No, this is our land. Look, my grandmother's native to us. All is my land. This whole fucking thing is my land. This whole earth belong to me. I'm the rich one. Fuck
we
that.
We're the rich one. Right.
All this shit belong to me. Like, let's stop this. All this belong to me.
Right.
Us. All this. Like, we got to get out of that. We created all this. And we got to stop being scared to take back over what's ours.
It's ours. Christopher Columbus, Thanksgiving, just had Thanksgiving. They stole this country.
Yeah, I don't celebrate that shit. Like, I know where my lineage come from. Like, you can still go back in. Like, Louisiana is heavy, and I'm about to dig into that come the beginning of the year. Like, top of the year, I'm about to dig into the West. Like, all the history in the West over here that nobody really talks about. Like, if people online talk about it, but there's nobody with as much influence over everybody like I have,
yeah,
that talks about it. So come the beginning of January, or that month that they call January, like I'm going to be, I'm about to put the spotlight on the West. Like everything going on over here. Then I'm going to show a lot of people how important Louisiana is and how much a lot of the people living in Louisiana are actually natives. Like a lot of people from Louisiana, think like y'all natives to that, like that's our land. Like a lot of y'all don't know that, so when I put this information out and I start waking y'all up, it's gonna be a shift over there.
Shout out to my kinfolk for letting me know that information. Now, let's get a little light, you know what I'm saying? You speak about, you know, black queens, you know what I'm saying? You know, ladies wanna know, man, you know, what Raspy likes? What type of woman Raspy likes? You know, what type of queens Raspy likes? But I can go on, man, you know, I got a cupcake of champagne, but
my brothers always told me that I was trained by my mother and my two sisters to live with any woman. I just think I'm at the point to where she just have to be willing to put our community first.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you willing to put the betterment of our community first? I already love you. Mm-hmm. In my line of work, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing if I didn't love you.
Right.
That is given. Like, I don't believe in being in love either. Like, I believe that love, you love people and things based on the relationship you have with them. You know what I'm saying? I believe that you love everything, every person differently. You know what I'm saying? You can never give no two people the same love, but you can have love for those people. Like, I don't believe in being in love. I believe in love puts us in the bind and makes us it makes us not pay attention to our true feelings.
I agree. Right.
And then we act on those impulses whenever they strike because you've been holding them back for so long.
Mm-hmm.
Because they that institutionalized thinking.
And we kind of lose ourselves.
Yes, we do. So that's how it is with me. It's all about the nation for me. You know what I mean? Like,
so she basically got to ride with you. Whatever.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? She got to be having the Most High first with her. Like, the Most High got to be first with her. That way she'll know that I'm first with her because I have to be seeking the Most High in order to be first with her.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because if you're not seeking for the Most High, you're not going to be finding me. You're not going to be on this vibration.
Right, right. You know, there's a lot of females, you know, they want to be with you for the fame and some that or what you got going on. Because, you know, I'm sure you can agree. When I'm talking to them, I don't even tell them what I got going on. I just
Hey, people think I use consciousness to get pussy. But the crazy part about it is that before I started with my queen, I was thinking to myself, if anybody should be able to use it to do it, it should be me. But I don't.
Right.
But see, also with me, like my dad conditioned me from a youth
right
to have a sex addiction. So now that I'm grown, I understand that more mentally. Like I say, it's all about the mind. Like my dad, from a youth, he conditioned me, that sex addiction, to think with my dick first all the time. Mm-hmm. Because as a kid, he had so much shit fucked up with him. You know, so he got in a wreck at 87, when he lost his 3 best friends, they died, he was in a coma. You know what I'm saying? He come out on my birthday, he leave when I'm 5, when he get all fucked up, you know what I'm saying? So the PI didn't see him coming out the club and shit all fucked up. You know what I'm saying? He lived like a $2.9 million lawsuit, but he trying to combat him losing his friends and all this shit. They got fake hair on his legs, longer than the other, pins and rods, you know what I'm saying, in this shit. So I used to have to see him every day leaving out the projects. He used to be at the top of the fucking tree, street, under the tree with his people. You know what I'm saying? Like, my daddy didn't move away. He moved around the block. Mm-hmm. So, you know, they say out of sight, out of mind. That's one thing for your daddy to be gone. I don't think about it. But another thing, to have to see your daddy every day you leave out the project. Because where he sits at is right next to the store. So every day you got to see your daddy. He don't do shit for you, but ask you if you dip your stick. So he the senior, I'm the junior. Wow. So I'm, as a kid, I'm looking for my dad's approval. Yeah. So I don't know it as a kid, but every day I leave out the projects, I'm trying to find a chick to sleep with.
Right.
So when I pass back, I tell my daddy, yeah, so I don't have to lie to him. And so I also make him look big in front of his peers. So he conditioned me over time to only think with my dickhead.
It's funny you say that because, you know, when I talk to certain women, that's right. And I talk to certain women I think it's all about reprogramming. You know,
yes.
You know, you talk to a certain woman, you know, you'd be a fool if you fall for a woman asks you for money, you give it to her. But I think it's all about reprogramming the L-O-V-E artist.
It's what she asking money for. What, you just coming to me to ask me for money just to ask me for money? You really need something, like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
I mean, I need $1 million.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, but if you coming to me to ask me for money just because you want to just come get money from me just because, or just really need something, like,
right.
we have to start. I see somebody, I don't know who posted about this, but they said we have to start being more spiritual with our money. And I feel it's more spiritual with our energy, not just our money. And I, you know what I'm saying? I always like to go past money when I talk about money because it's more than just the green dollar bill, that's currency.
And it's funny you said it because, you know, Dave Chappelle, what they offered them, what?
60,
but then.
But think about what.
Remember
think
about, what they offered him before.
Think about
you what, didn't take it.
What is 50 worth now? Is it more or less when he offered him the 50 now? What then, would that be worth? Yeah. That's what that would the question would be. What would the 50 that they offered him now? What would it be worth now? Hmm. How much would the 50 million that they offered him then when he turned it down? Would it be more than the 60 million? Or?
Yeah, because the dollar amount now is
shot.
You know, but 50 what 10, 12 years ago. Well, it was what they offered him 60, but I'm just saying, you're right. I mean, I'm sure he could have done more with it then compared to now.
But he might be at a space to where now he'd probably say, all right, y'all give me 60 million, but y'all had to give me total control. Like, I already know the games y'all play, that's why I left the first time.
Right.
So, because nobody knows his contract yet. So before, you know, I hear that.
I think he got like a 3-part thing with Netflix, or something like that.
But I'm about to put it in all that. I'm about to put in all this, giving our content, having to sell our content to them first. I'm about to build us a hub for us to have our own outlet for our media. So we ain't got to go to them for outlets to our media. I'm about to put boxes in our own house, our own media outlet, our own cable outlet. So if all y'all got networks, you know what I'm saying? Like y'all have series on Netflix, y'all have series on YouTube, all that. I'm building a platform for y'all. Like, we don't need nobody. I keep telling y'all that we don't need no one. Nobody. We send them to school, created by fools. They make every rule, expect them to lose. That's mental abuse.
Mental abuse.
Hell.
Yeah. And you think that is cool.